I joined the Foreign Agricultural Service, Department of Agriculture, in 1959, and my initial assignment was the Rice Bowl countries, Burma, Thailand, Cambodia, Laos, Vietnam. I wanted to get to know world agriculture. I was in the department for 2 years, went to Harvard to get a master's in public administration. It took 9 months, came back 1st of June, 1962, and my branch chief, Quentin West, who was a very good progressive branch chief, called me in and said, you know, I'd like to do some long-term supply and demand projections for the Asia branch, for our region of the world. And I said, well, that's a good idea, but you can't do Asia by itself. If you don't do the rest of the world, you won't know for sure whether commodities will flow into or out of the region. So then another week went by and he called me in again and he said, do you think you could do projections for the world? I said, yes. No one knew about this study except Quentin West, the branch chief. It never appeared on a plan of work, was never budgeted. So finally it came off the press in October of 1963. One of the journalists of U.S. News and World Report, and he said, let me talk with my editor. So a week or two later, both of them came in and we looked at it and went over it and they said, well, we think we want to do something with this. This was probably early October. So they went to work on an article and that article was scheduled to come out like in the November 26th issue of U.S. News and World Report. But John Kennedy was assassinated on November 23rd, so they had to tear that issue up and start all over again. I assumed that that was it. And then over Christmas, there was a newsstand, and on it was the January 6th issue of U.S. News and World Report with a cover story, Why Hunger to Be World's Number One Problem. They devoted 4 pages simply to summarizing the findings in the study. Things just sort of took off. Orville Freeman, by this time, had seen this cover story and he was pleased to have a study from his department getting this attention, but he had no idea that the study existed. So he invited me over to his office and we talked for a while and we hit it off. We got along very well. So they created a new organization in the Department of Agriculture called the International Agricultural Development Service. And Freeman appointed me administrator.